16 miles an hour right now in the metro, 16 up in Decorah, 26 miles an hour in Algona. These are sustained winds, not gusts. So still a little strong in spots, but that stands to reason as we've got some showers and even a couple thunderstorms out there. You can see the band ahead of the front just off to the southeast there. This is continuing to surge to the southeast, and as it does so, bring those stronger winds and isolated showers and storms along with it. So really patchy stuff. Don't be surprised still if you see a few showers or even a thunderstorm throughout the early to late evening hours here. But by tomorrow morning, we should be clearing that out. This was a look earlier. Hey Emmer sent this to me on Twitter. You can see some of the rain, a beautiful rainbow, and a pretty nice looking cloud out there. Thanks for sending that in. If you want to see your picture up here, just tweet it to me or find me on Facebook. 70 degrees still. Averages for this time of year are in the mid-50s, so ridiculously mild air still around for us. And you look around the state, not the case on a lot of locations behind this front. 56 Mason City, 53 in Spencer. That warm air now mainly off to the southern edge of the state here. 69 for Iowa City. Ottumwa sitting at 65. But around the metro, still warm. 68 for Osceola, 68 Knoxville, and 63 up there in Ames. So these temperatures continue to back down throughout the overnight hours here. Overnight lows around the upper 30s. And throughout the day tomorrow, not going to be nearly as warm as we had jumps in the last in our segments today of 7 degrees. Kind of ridiculous. Not going to be the case tomorrow. We lose those winds out of the southwest and bring an area high pressure in from the north, and that'll mean sunshine. But again, cooler air will be with us. Futurecast kicks the showers and storms off to the south by the morning hours. Does try to bring in a little bit of cloud cover into the morning hours through northeastern portions of the state. We'll have that, but as that high pressure takes hold, that will eventually clear out. On the backside of that high pressure, though, make way for an area of low pressure to drag another front through, and that's going to be the catalyst for more showers and the potential for more thunderstorms into Tuesday and into Wednesday as well. But winds don't remain strong for too much longer. Forecast winds are in the teens still through the morning hours, then eventually back down into the single digits by tomorrow evening. So they'll be moderate tomorrow, but not nearly as strong as we have seen, but eventually ramp up again ahead of that next system arriving on Tuesday. 40 degrees tonight, isolated showers and a few storms out there. Tomorrow, almost 30 degrees cooler, 54 degrees. But we'll see sunshine along with that. So still an absolutely beautiful day, really, no matter where you're at. Mid-50s through central portions of the state off to the southwest. Still chances for 60s, sunshine, really, no matter where you're at. Could see a few clouds to the north and to the northeast. But other than that, it's looking to be a dry day and really an absolutely beautiful day. So the winds will finally be manageable out there. So next few days here, we see quite the change. 59 degrees on Tuesday. That's the next chance for a little bit of rain, potential for some thunderstorms. After that, dodgy rain chances Wednesday and Thursday. Look at this weekend, though. Friday through Sunday, we get sunshine with temperatures climbing back to near 70.